Today in the news, we take a look at everything we know so far about the RTX 2060. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Nvidia's GTX 10 series Pascal GPUs were definitely the hallmark of great performance for great price, and one of the things that debuted with this generation was the amazing performance of their mobile counterparts. Thanks partly to what Nvidia calls Max-Q, you could get very close to desktop class performance on the laptop. This was mostly due to great chip binning, and a good power delivery system to go with it. Well, some leaks show that Max-Q is back for the RTX 20 series of GPUs, and with that came some leaks on the RTX 2060. The leaks come from tum_apisak on Twitter, so let's break them down. The RTX 2060 will come in two variants for laptops, a mobility or mobile and a Max-Q version. The main difference here is just the efficiency. The mobility or mobile variant are usually more powerful because they don't need to pass the Max-Q requirements. Max-Q will mostly be used in thin gaming laptops, while the mobile GPUs are used in thicker laptops with better thermal solutions for their higher performance. In terms of core clock speeds, the RTX 2060 mobile will start at 960 MHz, while the Max-Q will start at 975. Memory bus clocks turn things around with 1750 MHz for the mobile variant, which is the same memory clock as all of the other RTX cards out there right now, and 1500 MHz for the Max-Q version. Memory-wise, it looks like Nvidia decided to stick to 6GB for the 2060, although this time with GDDR6. If we look at the CUDA core count, we should see 1920 of them for both cards. I say should because while that spec wasn't leaked, we do see 30 compute units, and there are usually 64 CUDA cores per compute unit. Alright, so where does the RTX 2060 fit in terms of performance? Well, we don't know exactly because no actual GPU-specific scores were mentioned, except for the Final Fantasy benchmarks, but it looks like the mobile variant will be slotted between the GTX 1070 mobile and Max-Q. But what about the desktop version of the RTX 2060? A Gigabyte leak points to it having the exact same core count as the laptop version, but with a higher 1.2 GHz clock speed. I expected the core count thing, but 1.2 GHz seems a little slow when all of the other available RTX cards run at 1.4 GHz or higher. I would expect the same thing from the 2060. If we go back to the Final Fantasy benchmark that had the RTX 2060 in it, we can now see that this card was probably the laptop mobile version since it beat the Max-Q variant of the 1070. Now you might have noticed that I didn't mention anything about ray tracing. That's because the 2060 will probably not have it, even though it keeps the RTX moniker. Back at the Citi 2018 GTC conference, Nvidia CFO Colette Kress said that the cards will come out and will start with the ray tracing cards, implying that whatever came out after the first announcement wouldn't have it. And I don't blame them since frame rate with RTX on is significantly reduced. Now, if we look at the Turing architecture and we remove the ray tracing cores, we're still left with the tensor cores. Will the 2060 have them? I mean, yes, these cores are used to assist in the ray tracing abilities of the cards, although right now no games currently support it this way. But these cores could still be used for DLSS or machine learning, which would be a plus for the 2060. Personally, I hope the RTX 2060 doesn't disappoint. Sure, those are just leaks, and we don't really have any proper benchmark scores to compare to what we have right now. But since Nvidia has had time to see how that first launch happened and how the community reacted to it, I hope they find a way to bring value with the RTX 2060. I'm sure the performance bump compared to last generation will be significant. So far, they say about 30%, but it's all about that pricing. Mess that up and the community will roar again, that's for sure. Anyways, I decided to try this format of one topic video again because it allows me to dig a little bit deeper and give you more insight into what I'm thinking. Let me know what you thought down below, and while you're there, leave me a thumbs up if you liked it. As usual, stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Oh, don't forget, you can click right here to see the latest video, and right here to subscribe to the channel. This is free content, and this is the subscribe button, right? Alright, take care, guys.